Do you want that pro-looking multicam video for your podcast or live stream? Well, you can do that right now with the devices you have around your house. Using iPhones, Android, iPads, or full-on pro cameras, you can build the ultimate setup no matter your budget. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to create that multicam setup using just mobile devices and how Riverside allows you to switch whether you're streaming live or in the editor afterwards. And if you want to go for that pro setup, I'll show you how to use a switcher like an A10 Mini Pro or Rodecaster Video and how you can use multiple mirrorless cameras in that switcher also with Riverside, plus some AI tools for editing that multicam footage in minutes. So first off, whether you're doing solo content or you want to do a two-person in-person recording with video on both guests, you can do that with your mobile devices. Just download the free Riverside app on all the devices you plan to use. Log in with your account on every device, and we're going to treat each mobile device as a guest. So let's say it was you and one other in-person guest. I would have a mobile device pointed at you and another mobile device or iPad pointed at your remote guest. Then to make sure you capture great audio for you and your remote guest, I would plug in a USB microphone to each mobile device. Then whichever guest this camera is capturing, like this iPhone, give that person this microphone to speak into. Mount this on a tripod and you're good to go. Now I did a whole video on what USB mics specifically work with the iPhone so you can record in this kind of setup. So if you're interested, check out that video here and that link's in the description. Now, if you just wanted that multicam look for a solo live stream, you don't have to worry about the audio coming from these other devices, and I'll show you why in a minute. Now I'm actually gonna add a third camera angle, namely one connected to my computer, and I'm actually gonna set up the recording from there. So I'm gonna use Riverside. You can create a free account to do recording and live streaming, yes, completely for free, even to multiple destinations. And I'm gonna jump in to record in the studio. Now here on my computer, I'm using a mirrorless camera angle as my A-roll, and I'm gonna use my Rodecaster Pro 2 interface with this microphone for my audio. I'm gonna choose I'm using headphones, and I would typically wear headphones connected to my Rodecaster Pro, and let's join the studio. So now we have our main camera or A-roll, let's add those secondary angles. Here on the iPhone, logged into the same Riverside account, I'm gonna join the same studio. I'll go to record. Now I actually want to adjust my name. This way it'll make it easier in the editing and also for the live stream. I'm also going to flip the camera around because I want to use the rear camera, which is the higher quality one. And I'm also going to unlock portrait rotation so I can rotate it to landscape. Now when I click join, I'm actually looking at the other camera, my A-roll. And here's the important part. Click the three dots here in the menu and I want to mute my speaker. By muting the speaker on this device, now I can talk normally for my A-roll and my main audio input, and it's not gonna come through this phone speaker. Now I'm gonna set this camera up on a tripod next to me, and now I have two angles. I can talk to the second camera and my main camera. Now maybe I want a third angle, maybe of my desk, because I'm gonna be talking about some products. Well, I'm gonna join from my iPad using the same studio. I'm gonna rename this device. This is gonna be camera 3. I'll hit done. I'm gonna flip it to the rear-facing camera and then join the studio. Again, important on this device, I'm gonna hit those three dots and mute the speaker here on my iPad. And now I have a third camera angle where I can talk about products and show stuff on my desk and even switch between these camera angles later. Now, under the people settings here on the right, I'm actually going to mute the microphone on my secondary cameras because when I live stream, I just want my main audio. That's that channel down here. Also, I can rearrange which camera angle appears here in the grid just by clicking and dragging over. And I'm gonna show you how to switch between these layouts full screen in a second. Now, if I wanna set up some live stream destinations, I can go up to live stream here and I can multicast to YouTube, Twitch, even live stream on Riverside. And I can connect additional destinations like my LinkedIn, Facebook page, and more, and any custom RTMP destination. And remember, you can multicast completely for free in Riverside. Now, if you wanna upgrade to the Live Studio add-on, but then you can live stream in 1080p HD quality and remove the watermark. Live streaming quality without the studio add-on is 720. Now before I go live and record, I'm gonna go to the layout feature here, and I'm gonna go to the speaker full screen layout. Now, typically the speaker full screen layout will focus on the active speakers. So if you have other remote guests here in the studio and they start speaking, Riverside will automatically switch to them full screen. But because it's just me live streaming, I wanna switch between the angles manually. So I'm gonna leave it on that speaker full screen, but then I'm gonna use the pin feature. Now, if I roll over the different angles here on the right-hand side, you'll see the option to pin. This way I can click pin on camera 3, and now it's showing that angle to my live stream viewers. I can go to camera 2, talk to that. Now you also have some options with the Live Studio add-on to add a custom background, change the color behind the video, or if you wanna make sure your video goes edge to edge on those other destinations, you can go to the fit option here, remove your brand background, and now you're gonna be a full 16:9 video on all those social destinations. All right, I think we're ready to live stream and switch between those angles. And the great part is that camera angle 2 and 3 is being recorded separately in high quality, so I can download them all later, but also use them in the editor. So let's start streaming and recording. I'll hit the record button down here. And now I'm being live streamed to all those destinations, YouTube, Facebook, LinkedIn, X, and more. And I'm being recorded in high quality, all of the angles simultaneously. Then if I wanted to switch the angles, show camera 3, well, I can go to camera 3, show my USB microphone, talk about that. I can place my iPad somewhere else for a different kind of angle. Maybe I want to talk to camera 2. Now this is camera 2, and I'm addressing that, looking directly in that angle. And then I can go back to angle 1. Now you can add more mobile devices if you would like, additional iPhones, Android, doesn't matter, as long as they have the Riverside app, they can all be used as additional multicams. And all these angles are being recorded in high quality for editing later. If I wanted to, I can also go to the layout and go to speaker split screen, and my live stream viewers can see the other camera angles small, picture in picture. And if I wanted to, I can unpin myself, go to the grid option, and now they're seeing all three or however many cameras you have at the same time. Now let's say we were done recording. I'll hit the stop button down here, and I'm gonna show you what those multiple camera angles look like in the Riverside editor, and how you can quickly put it together. You see all those angles are now uploaded, so I'm gonna jump to the project to begin editing. So here I am on the project page, and all my cameras have finished processing. By the way, if you haven't seen the new design for the project page yet, I did a whole video walkthrough, I'll link it above and in the description, but now you can browse via multiple tabs to see your raw recording files, Made For You tab, which has our magic episode and AI show notes. Any edits that you've started, you can visit here, and all your exports are found in one place. Here on the recordings page, I can go down and you'll see each camera gets its own separate high quality track. So I can download the video for each of those tracks, but it's gonna be even easier to put it together in the Riverside editor. So I'm gonna go up here to the Create button and let's start a new edit. Now you'll see by default, all the camera angles are here in a grid format. But I'm gonna go over to the layout option here on the right-hand side, and I'm gonna go full screen. Now I have my A-roll camera, and you get that high quality video, the full transcript editing on the side, and I'm ready to switch angles. Now I can see right here in the transcript when I go to camera 3, and what I'm gonna do is create a new scene. I can roll my mouse over down here at the bottom left, you'll see add scene. You'll also see I can add it here from the transcript. Wherever my cursor is, just tap add, and now you'll see the new scene here, and I can choose what angle is visible. So when I click onto the video preview here, instead of me, I'm gonna click camera 3, and now I went to that camera 3 shot. Let's preview that change. It's me talking to A-roll camera, and now I have camera 3 right here. Then I see in the transcript where I go to camera 2, I'll add another scene here, click in and switch to camera 2. And if I want, I can also crop this because the shot was a little wide. So I'll crop in, focus on my face, preview that. And then when I look away back to camera 1, I'm gonna add another scene and go back to my A-roll camera. So now I can preview right here in Riverside where I go from camera 3 focusing on the desk, camera 2, which was my iPhone camera, and I go back to camera 1 when it's time for more A-roll content. And remember, you still have all the amazing AI tools available to you here in Riverside. Like in the AI producer, I can remove all pauses, adjust how I want that pace, remove filler words if your recording had any. Smart Mute will mute tracks when someone's not speaking, great for multi-guest podcasts and other interviews. And Smart Layouts is usually great when you have multiple people with different audio sources. But the way we did our live stream, there's actually no audio for those other camera angles. So Smart Layouts is not gonna be able to switch between those angles. But when you record with remote guests, like I do my video podcast every week, check out that Smart Layouts feature and it will focus on the active speaker. And then in those in-between moments where there's laughter or some crosstalk, Smart Layouts will automatically go back to that grid view side by side and then go back to focusing on the active speaker. Also, if you recorded an interview with just mobile devices in the Riverside app and you connected a USB mic per mobile device that was recording each guest, you can use that Smart Layouts feature and Riverside will automatically switch between those angles even for an in-person interview. And don't forget, you can add animated captions here in Riverside, add image and video overlays, text overlays like for names, lower thirds, and even animate those, apply your brand, and more. Now I'm gonna export this clip in 4K quality so I can show you how good all three camera angles will look in the exported file. So I'll choose 4K up here. Remember, I can export an audio-only version as well. Then I'll export video. I'll go back to my exports, and back here on the projects page, you'll see in the exports tab, that clip is processing. Now here's the final product once you export that 4K file from Riverside with multiple angles using mobile phones and iPads. Then if I wanted to switch the angles, show camera 3, well I can go to camera 3, show my USB microphone, talk about that. I can place my iPad somewhere else for a different kind of angle. Now this is camera 2 and I'm addressing that, looking directly in that angle. And then I can go back to angle 1. So that's a great way to have multiple camera angles with the devices you have now, whether you're live streaming solo, have remote guests, or even in-person guests. Now, if you want to use a video switcher and multiple mirrorless cameras, you can do that in Riverside as well. I use the A10 Mini Pro, which allows for four cameras to be connected via HDMI, and then it connects to your computer via a USB-C cable, and Riverside recognizes that automatically. You can also use the Rodecaster Video, which has great features for auto-switching between who's speaking, and you can input multiple XLR microphones. I did an entire walkthrough of how to use the Rodecaster Video and using it with Riverside. You can check that out above and the links below. Now let's go back and record, and I'll show you what it looks like to use a video switcher with Riverside. So here in the Riverside lobby, you'll see Blackmagic Design. That's actually my video switcher that Riverside recognizes automatically. And I'm using my Rodecaster Pro 2 for audio input and output. Now here I am in the Riverside studio again, and this is actually using the video switcher. And as you can see, I have both my A-roll camera here, I have a B-roll top-down camera right here, and I also have a Mac and Apple TV all connected to that Blackmagic A10 Mini Pro. Then here in Riverside, if I was live streaming or recording, I could switch between camera one. Now it's camera two, right here in Riverside, showing a top-down shot. I can show my Mac screen, which is input four on the A10 Mini, and even show a picture-in-picture style video, and that's all from the Blackmagic A10. Now I'm gonna start recording just like I did before and switch between the camera angles. Now the main thing to remember is Riverside can only record the main or program output. So right now I have camera one up, I'll go to camera two, show something on screen with the top-down camera. That's being recorded all in the same track in Riverside. I can also show my Mac screen, maybe do a screen share, tutorial style, and then go back to my A-roll camera. So for live streaming, this is great. You're switching between the live angles. Riverside's recording it all in high quality. But remember, you're not gonna have full separate tracks for each camera angle. So I don't have my top-down camera shot right now in Riverside because it's not being shown. And when I show my top-down camera, now I don't have my A-roll video being recorded in Riverside. Now, you can record directly to the SD card on your mirrorless camera, or you can upgrade to something like the A10 Mini Pro ISO, and that's a version of the video switcher that can record all the inputs individually to an external SSD, and then you would edit those later. But let me show you what it looks like in Riverside once I stop this recording. Now that the video is processed, you'll see here on the project page, I have exactly one video track. This is the mix, or whatever I was switching to live while recording. That's what was recorded here on the track. Then if I jump into the Riverside editor, you'll see whatever I switched to while I was recording, whether it was the A-roll, the B-roll, the top-down, or maybe even the Mac screen, which was another HDMI input, that's what was recorded. I can't switch to another angle here in the editor because it was only recording what was live on screen. Now, if your video switching is on point, or maybe you even have a producer doing that for you, that can really cut down on editing time and would be great if you have multiple in-person guests. But remember, you'll need another solution for recording the full video tracks from each camera if you wanted to. But using a video switcher like this, you still get access to all the AI producer tools like removing pauses and filler words. Smart layouts, again, you won't be able to apply because there's really only one video track. But you can apply Magic Audio, make any microphone sound studio quality, use our background music library, image, video, and text overlays, and more. Now, if you want to learn how to do a top-down shot like I showed in this video, I have a whole video just on that. I'll link it above. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that like button. Lots of walkthroughs and tutorials coming soon, which I'll put that Rodecaster video right up here. And if you have any questions, leave comments below this video. I answer you personally. Lots of features coming to Riverside soon too, and you'll see videos here on the channel as they come out. Thanks for watching. We can't wait to see what you create.